Welcome to Ella's Beef Easter's Radio Aircheck and Classic TV Channel.
Casey Kasem started his American Top 40 show in 1970 on 7 radio stations. He's now got over 325 stations under his belt, and he's still collecting them like postage stamps. The sun never sets on the American Top 40 empire, and every week millions of people around the world hear Casey Kasem feature every one of Billboard magazine's Top 40 hits. Last month, those millions heard this.
Hello again and welcome to American Top 40. I'm Casey Kasem and I'm all set to count down the 40 best-selling songs in the USA this week according to Billboard National Chart. We have 7 debut tunes in the survey and a new one at the top. Let's get it all started right here.
Number 40.
Here's the tune that won Best Song of the Year in the Academy Awards by actor Keith Carradine, who also wrote it. From the motion picture Nashville, I'm Easy.
Not my way to love you just when no one's looking. Not my way, I'm easy. Give the word, I'll play your game. So that's how it ought to be, 'cause I'm easy.
26-year-old Keith Carradine and the tune that won the Academy Award this year at number 40 gets I'm Easy.
American Top 40.
You know, 1840 is heard coast to coast and around the world every week on great radio stations like KRAZ, Farmington, New Mexico, WIBM, Jackson, Michigan, and KELP, El Paso, Texas. We're up to number 34 in our countdown of the 40 biggest, the Tramps. They move up 5 this week, second week on the chart with That's Where the Happy People Go. At number 34 in popularity this week in America, that's the Tramps, and That's Where the Happy People Go. You know, summer is almost here, and if you're going to be wandering farther away from home than this station's radio signal can reach, then you ought to take along one of our worldwide listening directories. It lists every station American Top 40 has heard on in the 50 states and many other nations around the world. If you'd like to have one of our directories, I'll give you our address following this record. Here now is Peter Frampton with a former Top 10 record called Show Me the Way. Falling from 26 to 33 this week, Peter Frampton and Show Me the Way. Now, for those of you who'd like one of our worldwide listening directories, here's the address I promised. Send a self-addressed stamped envelope to P.O. Box 8170, Universal City, California, 91608. And now on with our survey of the 40 top hits of the nation. This is AT40. I'm Casey Kasem, and the countdown rolls on.
Number 27.
This week we have 6 British acts in the countdown. Peter Frampton, Queen, Fleetwood Mac, Rolling Stones, Wings, and this young lady, 23-year-old Maxine Nightingale, with Right Back Where We Started From. That song went to number 2 5 weeks ago on American Top 40, Right Back Where We Started From, Maxine Nightingale. We have a very offbeat question here from New York City. This listener wants to know if there's ever been a Top 40 hit by a vocalist who wasn't a human being. Well, believe it or not, a group of 5 non-human living creatures did make it into the Top 40 once. And the ridiculous details are coming up.
The hits from coast to coast. American Top 40.
We're coming to you from Hollywood, and the countdown continues on our way to a new number one song in the nation. Here are the Doobies at number 16. They move up with Taking It to the Streets. Doobie Brothers at number 16, moving from 21 with Taking It to the Streets. Well, now on American Top 40, let me get to that letter from Frank Turchio Jr. of Barkchester, New York. Most unusual. You see, Frank wants to know if there's ever been a top 40 hit featuring a vocalist that was not human. Not a machine, but a living creature. Listen to this. You know, I think you set us up for that one, Frank. Back in 1955, that was the only time in the history of mankind that a non-human living creature made it to the top 40 as a singer. There were five creatures, as a matter of fact, a pack known as the Singing Dogs, belting out Stephen Foster's standard, Oh, Susanna. Now, maybe you've heard the flip side of that record around Christmas time, the dogs barking jingle bells. The whole idea belonged to a Danish musician named Don Charles. He recorded five dogs barking at different notes, then edited together the separate barks to sound like the dogs were singing. And he had himself a top 40 hit.
Casey is coast to coast.
Well, it's time now for the number one song in the USA. And it's a song that must feel very comfortable in this number one position because just 3 weeks ago, that's where it was. The last time a song fell out of the number one spot and then moved back in a few weeks later was in December of last year. That's when Casey and the Sunshine Band did it with That's the Way I Like It. This week, after spending a couple of weeks in the runner-up position, Paul McCartney and Wings take over the number one spot for the second time with the same song. Here it is, the most popular song in the country, Silly Love Songs.
You'd think that people were bad enough a silly love song.
Casey Kasem's American Top 40 is heard around the world every week. His commercial voiceovers are confined to the States, where he sells the virtues of foods, machines, and other products from the American cornucopia. Like the nationally syndicated disc jockey, the national pitchman can make more money than his local colleague. On that local level, radio stations are always desperate to make ends meet. The speed and mania of American rock radio is a constant reminder that AM stations try to convince us to listen to them because they've got to get the listening figures to appeal to advertisers. American commercial radio is at least as much a commercial business as a communications facility. One sad result is that stations that don't come near the top of the ratings league are constantly changing either their announcers or their formats. In New York City, WABC has been the number one rated pop station for so long that one by one its AM competitors have thrown in the towel. WMCA going all talk, WINS all news, and WHN first easy listening and then all country. Earlier this year, WABC's sister station in Chicago, WLS, enjoyed a similar triumph. Its years-long domination of runner-up rocker WCFL resulted in CFL changing format to automated, beautiful music, giving every disc jockey a chance to wish listeners an emotional goodbye. It gave us the rare opportunity of hearing how a great American rock station dies.
Monday evening, CFL switches to easy listening and soft instrumentals. And to many of you, it'll be like losing an old friend. If you like rock and contemporary music and lyrics, where will you turn Tuesday? The answer? FM 96, BBM FM, where your friends are waiting.
CFL, number 9, 557. After years of preparation for a Jesuit ministry and flunking the celibacy and poverty questions on his final exam, Dickie Shannon has turned to a life of rock and roll radio. Father Shannon?
Yes?
It has been nice working with a professional, and someday I hope I have the opportunity to do so.
Bless you.
I just think he has made the sign. Anyway, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everyone here at the world's greatest rock and roll radio station, Super CFL, especially Chuck Lee, the Alabama Flash, my engineer. Really, really the world's greatest. If it hadn't been for him, I don't think I would have survived here 2 minutes. And John Gannis, my newsman, they put up with much. What do you have to say about that? Do you agree?
More than you know.
I'm thankful to have had the opportunity to be here and to work with some true professionals. Jingle! There you go. Till the next time we meet, may God grant you long life, health, happiness, peace, serenity, wisdom, and courage. Goodbye forever from Jim Bernard Hebel at Super CFL.
9:55 with Tim Kelly. Well, these are my last words. CFL. I feel like I should have something heavy to say. But I don't can't think of a thing. Don't let your meatloaf?
No, that's no good.
Well, what the hell? Thanks. Goodbye. Stay high. CFL. Dickie Shannon, 358.
Wonderful people. I'm sure as hell gonna miss you.
Be good. This is Michael Scott. Life is a rock, and for 14 years, CFL rolled us all. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
CFL at Bob Dearborn. It's 1:56 in Chicago. Super Jock, and he is. We'll be along here in just a few minutes. You know, it's a good thing we have songwriters. A lot of times, they know the words that we can't find. And that's why I want to dedicate this next song to all the special people that I've come to know and love, CFL staffers and listeners alike, who've made these last 6 years such a very special experience for me. Hey, Al, Polish Prince, hit that button one last time.
Monday, March 15th, marks another milestone in Chicago radio when WCFL changes from rock to beautiful music. This change will eliminate your multiple choice on AM radio. So we at WDAI invite you over to FM. There are 8 different rock stations on the Chicago FM stereo dial, ranging from very progressive to top 40 and all points in between. WDAI, long known as Chicago's best rock, awaits your arrival. And here's what you can expect. Chicago's best rock at 94.7. CFL with an important programming reminder. At approximately 4:45 this afternoon, Mr. Lujack will be delivering his last major address to the nation from this radio station. And the title of Mr. Lujack's address will be Several Reasons Why You Should Keep Listening to CFL and Not Pay Any Attention to What Those Rock and Roll Stations Are Saying. And now it's time for Larry Lujack's major address to the nation. Now, hey, I'll be honest with you. I like rock and roll. It's junk, but I like it. But I think that most people like a little of everything in music. I mean, I like Led Zeppelin and Boogie Fever and all those, but I also like Moon River by Henry Mancini. So if you think that perhaps you have reached a stage in your life where you've had enough screaming guitars and drag race and Zip Cream commercials to last you for the rest of your life, hey, just keep it on CFL and calm way down. Now, I've heard the tapes of what we're going to be playing starting at 7 o'clock tonight, and it's pretty stuff. If you like songs like Aquarius, which I do, when the moon is in the seventh house, you know, I think maybe you'll like it. At least give it a shot. Make sure that at 7 o'clock tonight, your radio is set on CFL, and you'll find it very soothing and relaxing. It will help you lighten the burden of reality. Plus, it is great music to make love to. Now, let's see a show of hands out there in the audience. How many of you like to make love? Well, hey, if you like to make love, you're going to love this radio station, because that's the kind of music we're going to be playing. And there is, of course, one more reason why you should keep listening to CFL. You see, notice I'm not saying goodbye. That's because I ain't going nowhere. I'm needed here, and I'm going to be right here again tomorrow afternoon from 2 till 6, playing the most beautiful music that you have ever heard in your whole life. So I'll just say so long for now, because lovers never say goodbye.
When WCFL died this March, many of its listeners declined Larry Lujack's polite invitation and started tuning into rock stations on the Chicago FM dial.